Excuse me, puppies. Hey, what's going on, everyone? I am J.A. Dudley. Just got home with this, the Renogy Smart Shunt. Gonna hook it up, see how it works out. See if I can get it to connect to the Renogy One Core. And some people online on the Renogy app that received this, they said they can't get it to connect to the Renogy One Core. They can get it to connect via Bluetooth to their phone, but I'm gonna open it up, set it up, and see how it goes. Well, here it is, a Smart Shunt. Do a quick unboxing. I could do that with one hand. Came with the instruction booklet. What is this? Warranty card. And the Smart Shunt. Here it is. It's not as big as what I was expecting from the pictures, but looks good. Here's the temperature sensor, some of the screws, and the wires that are to connect the positive for down here, so you can power this thing, because it goes negative to negative right there. So I'm gonna hook it up, set it up, and see what we can get. Oh, here we go. Got the cover released so you can see how the shunt actually looks. And I also have to take off this cover here so I could have the temperature sensor and the B1. That's a battery one, so this thing can be powered. Stopped by Hall's Electric, got some 4-gauge wire right over here so I could connect to the shunt and to the wires. I'm gonna have to get a bus bar for all my connections. All right, now I have all the wires that need to be connected on here, connected onto the shunt. And now to hook it up to the batteries and my solar system. Well, I have the shunt connected. I have to put the covers on it. And now all it's doing is beeping. I'm wondering if that's because it needs to get paired up with something from Bluetooth. So I'm gonna go grab the Renogy One Core and see if we can pair this thing up. All right, well, brought my Renogy One Core out here with a battery pack because I turned everything off. Let's see if we can add a device. Hey, first try, it found the Smart Shunt. Let's check that box. Come on, check the box. I am trying to check the box. Nope, we already got the controller. There we go. So let's uncheck the controller. Let's add the Smart Shunt. Add it successfully. You can now manage the device. And just like that, the Smart Shunt is connected. I did not try and connect it to my phone first. I just directly connected it to the core. Now let's see what information. Oh, battery amp hour. What is that? 2, 4, 6, 8. 1200. Oops. 1200 amp hours. Save. Edited successfully. Low alarm is triggered. Yes, because it's been a crappy day. No sun. So is that it? Is that all that it shows? There's a shunt. Maybe I need to check on the app and see if it shows anything on there. But the shunt is showing that it has power and it has Bluetooth connection. Let me grab my other phone. Open up the app. Oh, I forgot. I have the internet turned off. So Let me turn all that stuff back on and come back so I can try and use it. Oh, wait. Offline. Is it going to show anything? Showing information. Well, it's offline from the internet. So, yeah, got to get the Starlink back up and go from there. Let's turn that inverter on and got to turn on the other inverter. Oh, well, the shunt is showing that it's pulling power already. All right, now we have internet to the Renogy One core. Starlink is on, smart shunt is showing we are at 0%. And what is charge controller is saying we are at 12.5. So I'm wondering if it's because the smart shunt hasn't been charged up or anything. So let's do that now. Let's go to the switch bot. And with the switch bot, press that, start up the generator. Then let's head back over to the smart shunt and see what changes in information we get. So now it should be charging. Move my finger out the way. So now it's charging from the generator, going through the 3000 watt inverter charger. And let's see, let's go into the smart shunt, see what we got. So time to full charge, 17 hours and 30 minutes. So we got a ways to go. Most likely that's going to change once the inverter charger gets up to speed. But again, it's been a crappy day, all gray all day. So this is looking good. Just the data that I wanted to see. So for everyone, yes, we see that. For everyone that was having problems with their smart shunt, I didn't try and connect it to my phone first. I went straight to the Renogy One core, and that's pretty much it. It's over there still beeping. The inverter charger is charging it up, and I'm going to take the Renogy One core back inside the house. Hope y'all enjoyed, learned something. This is my setup. Shalom.